Hello students, today your video topic is white box testing. So what is the white box testing, software testing? White box testing is a testing of a software solution, internal structure, design and coding. In this type of testing, the code is visible to the tester. It focuses primarily on verifying the flow of input and output through the applications, improving design and usability. White box testing is also known as clear box testing, open box testing, and structural testing. It is one of two parts of box testing approach to software testing. Involve testing from an external or end user type perspectives. On the other hand, white box testing is based on the inner working of an application and revolves around internal testing. This is as shown in the diagram for the white box testing. These are the first part, a test case input. The next one, application code, and next one, test case output. This is a three-way testing, to be unit testing, integration, and system testing. Basically, white box testing is applied for the design and structure only, not for the programming, functional, and coding. Programming, functional, and coding testing is based on the black box testing, means backend, back users, critical, credential. This is known as the black box testing. Means all work should be allotted and operated by the backend or black side or hidden only. For example, in particular company to manufacturing the software and application. In this software and application, which part is hidden for the customer or client? This part is applied for the black box testing. Which part is show for the customer, for example front end view, it can be applied for the white box testing. Next one, what do you verify in white box testing? So first one, internal security hole, broken or poorly structured path in the coding process, the flow of specific input through the code, expected output, the functionality of conditional loops, testing of each statement, object and function on an individual basis. These are the white box testing involve the testing software code. The testing can be done at system integration and unit level of software development. One of the basic goal of white box testing is to verify a working flow of an application. It involves testing a series of predefined input against expected or desired output so that when a specific input does not result in the expected output, you have encountered bugs. How do you perform white box testing? There are the two-way procedure, two steps are defined by the how to perform in white box testing. First one, understand the source code, and second step, create test cases and execute. To give you a simplified explanation of white box testing, we have divided into basic steps. This is what tester do when testing an application using the white box testing technique. So first one, step one, understand the code, the source code. The first thing a tester will often do is learn and understand the source code of the application. Since white box testing involves the testing of the inner working of an application, the tester must be very knowledgeable in the programming language used in the application they are the testing. Also, the testing person must be highly aware of secure coding practices. Security is often one of the primary objectives of testing software. The tester should be able to find security issues and prevent attack from hacker and new user who might inject malicious code into the application, either knowledgeable and unknowledgeable. The next step two, create test cases and execute. The second basic step to white box testing involves testing the application source code for proper flow and structure. One way is by writing more code to the test application source code. The tester will develop little test for each process or series of process in the application. This method requires that the tester must have initiate knowledge of the code and is often done by the developer. Other methods include manual testing and try and error testing. The use of testing tool as we will explain further on this code of the next articles. This is a normal example of white box testing. This is a class. Next is a function. This is the end part. This is normal code, how to design of white box, how to design to white box testing. This is structural and designing of code, not apply for the actual function and actual methodology of your writing the code, only how to design the code for the piece of the program. This is normal example, simple example of white box testings. Next one, white box testing techniques. A major white box testing technique is code coverage analysis. Code coverage analysis eliminates gap in the test case suite. It identifies area of a program that are not considered or exercised by the set of test cases. Once gaps are identified, you create test cases to verify untested path of the code, thereby increasing the quality of the software. There are two techniques, statement coverage and branch coverage. Statement coverage, this technique requires every possible statement in the code to be tested at least once during the testing process of software engineering. Next one, branch coverage. This technique checks every possible path. For example, if else statement, for loop statement, if then else statement. These are the conditional statements of the software applications. Apart from above, there are numerous coverage types such as the condition coverage, multiple condition coverage, path coverage, function coverage, etc. Each technique has its own merits and attempt the test all parts of software code. Using statement and branch coverage, you generally attain 80 to 90% code coverage, which is sufficient. Next topic is types of white box testing. White box testing encompasses several testing types used to evaluate the usability of an application, block of code, or specific software packages. The first one, unit testing. It is often the first type of testing done on an application. Unit testing is performed on each unit or block of code as it is developed. Unit testing is essentially done by the programmer. As a software developer, you develop a few lines of code, a single function or an object, and test it to make sure it works before continuing. Unit testing helps identify a majority of bugs early in the software development lifecycle. Bugs identified in this stage are cheaper and easy to fix. For example, normally XYZ, for example, software testing, it's a book. In this book, there are 12 chapters, 12 module. So 12 modules means 12 unit, and every unit will check by the testers. Then next one, all the units to be combined, complete by the books, for example, software testing. And this is also known as the integration. First, you have to divide, then unit wise, testing, combine means integration. Once again, testing, this is integration testing and unit testing. Next one, testing for memory leaks. Memory leaks are leading causes of slower running application. A quality assurance specialist who is experienced at detecting memory leaks is essential in case where you have a slow running software application. Apart from the above, there are two main types of the white box testing: white box penetration testing and white box mutation testing. So penetration testing is, in this testing, the tester or developer has full information of the application source code, detailed network information, IP address info, and all server information the application runs on. The aim is to attack the code from several angles to expose security threats. Next one, mutation testing. Mutation testing is often used to discover the best coding technique to use for expanding a software solution. Next is the white box testing tools. Below the list of white box testing tools are available in market. So first one, Parasoft JTest, means Java Test, ECL IMA, NUnit, PyUnit, HTML Unit, and CPP Unit. There are the many testings are available in white box testing. Next one, advantages of white box testing is, first one, code optimization by finding hidden errors. White box test cases can be easily automated. Next one, testing is more thorough as all path are usually covered. And next is, testing can start early in SDLC even if GUI is available. Next one, disadvantages of white box testing. White box testing can be quick, complex, and expensive. Developer who usually execute white box test cases detect it. The white box testing by developer is not detailed can lead to production errors. White box testing require professional resources with a detailed understanding of programming and implementation. White box testing is time consuming. Bigger programming application take a time to test fully. So this is a white box testing, and thank you.